Hi guys, welcome back. If you're new here, ako po si Matilda Brat. And no, hindi po ako na scam. Before I bought the book from Shopee, I was about 80% sure na fake siya. But then, I wanted to give the seller a chance. And also, I want to know what a fake book looks like. So, binili ko pa rin yung libro. In this video, I will show you the book that I bought. And then later, I will give you tips on how to spot a fake book and how to avoid buying them. But before I do that, I am giving away these books. So if you haven't joined yet, just go ahead and click on the link above. Now let's go and check out the book.
So I recorded the unboxing kasi naisip ko if the book is really fake, magpapa-refund ako sa Shopee. And if magpapa-refund ka kasi sa Shopee, you need an evidence. So kaya na-record ko na itong unboxing. Medyo nagulat lang ako kasi maliit lang itong package. I expected it to be a hardcover kasi yan. Kalagay Shadow and Bone by Leigh Bardugo, and then hardcover. Doon din sa Shopee store ng seller, hardcover din yung nakalagay doon. So I expected something thicker and bigger than this. And the seller pala was from Indonesia. And this book costs 442 pesos. Ayan siya. It's so manipis. Para sa 442 pesos. Pero maayos naman yung packaging ng libro. May bubble wrap pa nga. Tapos itong papel na ginamit nila pang cover ng book. Medyo makapal naman. So here's the book, guys. Ayan. Manipis nga siya talaga. Ito yung book, guys. I don't have a copy of the original na hardcover nito, but I grabbed a picture sa internet and talaga hindi sila magkamukha. Kasi yung sa internet na nakita ko, makapal. Tapos ito, manipis lang siya. I think what they're trying to achieve is something like this. Mga ganito. Yung maliliit na mga hardcover. I don't know what they're called. Basta maliliit sila. So, ito. Maliit. So, if you compare them, medyo magkasize sila. But this one, you can see there. So, pagtingin ko dito sa likod, ito yung unang napansin ko. Medyo ano siya, faded yung barcode niya compared dito. Ayan, it's very clear. Tapos ito siya, ayan, malaki. Tapos medyo ano talaga siya, faded. And then yan, and then dito, if makikita niyo yung edges, hindi talaga pantay yung pagkakaputol or pagkat nila. Wait, kasi ito, ayan. Ayan, no, makikita nyo. Very smooth ng pagka-cut nila nito. Ayan. Samantalang ito, hindi siya smooth. Tapos, ayan. Makikita nyo dyan. Parang tinagtad. Ayan, may mga zigzag something. Tapos dito din. Yan. Mga zigzag lines. Yung ganito. Makakita nyo. Parang hindi siya even pagkaputol. Yan pa. Yan. Nakakita ko. Mga sides niya. As you can see. Yan. And then, kung napapansin nyo, ayun siya. Hindi malinis yung pagkakadikit. Tapos, ano lang talaga siya. Very plain paper. White paper lang. As you can see there. So, may mga dikit-dikit siya dito. Ayan. Compared sa mga ganito, yung originals, yung original na books. Ayan. Dinikit siya, pero even naman. See, there. Pero ito siya, hindi talaga. Tapos plain paper. Ayan, oh. Dito sa likod, ganun din. Tapos may parang babo sa loob. Dito din, may mga babos-babos siya dito. So, there. So, as I've said, wala akong copy ng ganito na cover. Ganito na version ng cover. But what I have is this one. Ito yung nabili ko na isa. So if I compare it, I know different sila ng edition. I'm not sure ano edition to. I'm not sure ano edition din ito. Pero very different sila. So there. I'll show you the map. So, ayan yung sa ganitong ano, version. Malaki. Malaki yung print. And then the map. Tapos wala naman siyang ganitong table of contents. Ito. Wala talaga. And then yung map. Ito nga. Nasa huli pa. Dito, ito yung pinakauna. Ayan, malaki siya. Tapos dito, maliit lang yung print. And then yung ito. Ayan, yung sinasabi ko na full print siya. Tapos dito. Ayan. Two pages. I mean, back to back, may ginawa nila yung cover, yung map. Tapos medyo darker itong map dito. Yung print medyo darker. Compared dito. So, ayan.
Now that you've seen what a fake book looks like, I will be giving you tips on how to avoid buying them. Tip number one, know what you are buying. Siguraduhin mo na alam mo yung binibili mo para hindi ka magulat. Be an informed buyer. So read everything in the description. Check if it's a hardcover, a paperback, brand new, pre-loved, reprint, everything. In my case, doon sa libro na nabili ko, wala akong masyadong nakitang important information about sa book. Yung description niya, medyo konti lang yung naisulat. Number two, check for actual pictures. So if there's none, make sure to ask the seller for the actual pictures. Minsan kasi, sellers who sell fake books will just grab pictures from the internet and claim that those are theirs. I found a tip from Facebook. Sabi nila, if you have a feeling that the seller is just grabbing pictures from the internet, ask them for a specific picture of the book. Like, make them take a picture of a specific chapter or a specific page of the book. You can also ask them to write your name on a piece of paper and then put that name on the specific page of the book. In my case, the seller failed to show me actual pictures of the book. Kaya lalo akong nagduda na peke talaga yung binibenta niya. Tip number 3, check for reviews. How many stars? Are there videos or pictures from other buyers or any comment that can help you with your purchase? Are there any negative reviews? So when checking for reviews, don't just read the positive ones, also read the negative ones kasi may mga importante details din kayo na makukuha sa mga negative na reviews. So I looked for reviews pero walang review yung book na binili ko. Parang ako pa yata yung pinakaunang bumili. Tip number 4, know the seller. Is the seller local or international? May mga review ba yung store niya? If the seller is already a reputable bookstore like National Bookstore, fully booked, or other bookstores, then congratulations. But if not, make sure to ask questions. In my case, the seller was from Indonesia. And after a few weeks, habang hinihintay ko na dumating yung book, I found out that the seller was banned from Shopee. So I think my savior's offense sila na nagawa. So yun, parang confirm na peke nga talaga yung binibenta nila. Sad. And tip number 5, ask for questions. Ask if there are flaws or damages. Ask if may mga punit or mga stain ba yung book. If there's anything else that you need to know about the book. May pangalan ba ng seller, nakasulat, mga ganun bagay. So, if something is not clear, make sure to ask. In my case, I did ask the seller kung original ba yung book or if it's a reprint. And the seller said that it's an original from their store, but eventually he lied. I'm just so thankful that I was able to get a refund from Shopee. They were able to return the 402 pesos na ginastos ko doon sa libro. You can apply these tips not only when buying books but also when buying other items online. I hope you learned something from this video. And if you have questions about me or how to get a refund from Shopee or any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss any of my new videos. Thank you for watching. Till next time, bye!